This is the RV Advisor Podcast with your host, Tom Alexander. Get all the latest information, trends, advice from experts, stories from the road, and more in the world of recreational vehicles. Now, here's Tom.
And welcome to the RV Advisor Podcast. My name is Tom Alexander, and joining us today, it is the co-founder and CTO of Boondockers Welcome, Anna Mast. Hi, Anna.
Hi, nice to talk to you today.
Well, it's great to have you, and I know you're calling us from Ontario today, Ontario, Canada. Specifically, where in Ontario?
I'm in Kitchener, so that's southern Ontario. We're about an hour outside of Toronto.
Ah, okay, gotcha. Got a few friends in Toronto, so that's great. And so not too far from the big city, right?
That's right.
Yeah. Now, you know, Boondockers Welcome is such an interesting platform and entity. So can you tell us a little bit about where the idea came from for Boondockers?
Absolutely. So my co-founder, Mary Ann Edwards, also happens to be my mother.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's a mother-daughter team.
Gotcha.
So she's been RVing for probably about 15 years, maybe a little more than that, maybe more like 18 years. Mm-hmm. And pretty much as soon as my younger sister moved out, she got an RV and hit the road.
Yeah.
And so she had probably a dozen or more years ago now started some travel guides for boondocking in the Southwest, and they had quite a good following. She has a separate website that she sells those on, which is Frugal RV Travel, and they're called the Shunpiker Guides, the Frugal Shunpiker Guides to RVing. Anyway, she had built up a good following of people doing that, but there's no real opportunity for free boondocking on public lands in the Northeast, the more populated areas, which is, of course, where we're from. She's also from Southern Ontario. And so she had sort of had the idea. We have one of my cousins is did a lot of traveling using couch surfing, and she thought that was a really cool idea, which just, you know, people stay on your couch. And she thought, oh, she's all these RVers who, you know, you're driving through the country roads and you see RVs parked at the end of driveways all the time on these, you know, lovely rural properties. She's like, I wonder if there's, you know, an opportunity for me to do something similar to couch surfing in the RVing space, if we could have, you know, people who are willing to host other RVers on their property, which is way less intrusive than couch surfing. You're not forced to open up your actual home. You know, your RVers come and they're the best guests because they bring everything they need with them.
Right.
So that was sort of the seed of the idea.
Yeah. And so a boondocking is what's another word for boondocking?
Well, so let's see. I think blacktop camping is something that people will call it, or that's if you're maybe in a parking lot. In Australia, they will call it free camping or a freedom camping, I think, is the word there. But here it's just, I mean, camping without hookups, right?
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
Camping in the boonies.
Right.
Wally docking is a term that gets used for parking in Walmart parking lots overnight.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's great. So, you know, it's just wherever you are, set up camp, so to speak. It's pretty interesting. Now, you've developed the site. Tell us a little bit about how the site's been developed and also where your first hosts came from.
Right. As I mentioned, Marianne is my mother, and she had come to me sort of with this idea. I have a background. I'm a computer engineer.
Wow.
And when she came up with this idea, I happened to be on maternity leave after having my oldest son. And here in Canada, we are lucky. We get a considerable amount, about 12 months of maternity leave. So
yeah.
I had a good stretch of time where I wasn't working a full-time job, and I said, you know, I think I have the technical skills that I could develop this site for you. And so it worked out as a real win-win situation. She got to spend a bunch of time with her new grandson, and I got a little bit of time away and time to use my brain in the way that I most enjoy using it. And so I took a first stab and developed the site back in 2012. And then Mary Ann had a good following, as I'd mentioned, of her travel guide, people who had purchased her travel guides. And she sent an email out to them all, saying that we were starting this up, and we had about 200 of them sign up as founding members. So they have founding lifetime free memberships forever. They were our founding members. So we started off with about 200 hosts.
I'm sorry, with 200 hosts, did you say?
200, yeah, about 200 hosts, and that was back in 2012.
Wow, that's amazing. That's so now, how many now? I mean, it's you've got you started with 200. Where's it all going?
Well, so we started with 200, and we are almost at 10 times that number now. So we are just, I looked today, as of today, we have 1,945 hosts.
No
so
kidding.
Just shy of 2,000. Yep.
Wow, that's fantastic. So 2,000 right around the corner, I'm sure. And They're located where? I mean, are they all over the place, all over the United States and Canada?
So the vast majority are in North America. About 25% of them are in Canada. The other three quarters are almost all in the United States. We have about 3% total that are outside of North America as well. We've got, you know, about a dozen in Australia, which has a pretty big RVing contingent, although we haven't really taken off there. But then a few others in Europe, one in Mexico. I think there's one in Hawaii. Usually those are people who have joined as guests when they've traveled through North America, and then they've returned home and just listed their location as a way to pay it forward.
Wow, that's great. We're speaking with Anna Mast. She is the co-founder and CTO of Boondockers Welcome. And it's just fascinating to me that this has just grown and has become a real true community. And tell us a little bit about how the site works.
Essentially, our hosts let you stay on their private property for a night or two. Some will offer a few more than that. Guests can search the site before you even sign up. You can search and look at all of the hosts that we have listed. Mm-hmm. And it's funny, we called it Boondockers Welcome when we started because we assumed that hosts would just offer a piece of land for guests to stay on overnight without, you know, the fear of the dreaded knock on the door in the middle of the night. But as it turns out, our hosts are so generous. Most of them, about 75% of them will offer an electric hookup of some sort. Mm-hmm. 65% of them offer a water hookup. Almost half of them will let you use their Wi-Fi. We encourage our guests to offer an honorarium as a thank you just if those services are offered. But if you don't use any of those services, the actual stay with a host is free.
Yeah.
All of our hosts offer that location for free. Just if you want to have a safe place to park for the night. So you can sign up as a guest. Even before signing up, as I said, you can see all of the host listings we have on the site. Once you have a guest subscription for a year, then you can message any of our hosts, send them a stay request with your dates that you're interested in, and then the hosts, they're encouraged to fill out sort of an availability calendar, but then they can accept or decline because we know that sometimes, you know, our hosts are just individuals and they have lives too. So they may not be able to accept every request that comes their way. Mm-hmm. But you make your request and the host accepts, and then the details of the host's location will be shared with the guest. And the stay happens, and then everybody leaves a nice review for each other afterwards.
Yeah, yeah, and it really is a true community. And I'd like to know, you know, what do you think it is that makes someone decide, hey, you know what, I want to be a host?
A lot of our hosts are RVers, and that was sort of what we had anticipated when we created the site, was that it would be RVers hosting other RVers. It turns out we have a lot of people who are former RVers. Maybe they, you know, can't RV anymore for, you know, reasons of health or other things that have gotten in the way, but they miss the life and they enjoy talking to guests who are still RVing and sort of living vicariously through them. Some of them are interested in becoming RVers, and so they become hosts beforehand to try and learn more and learn from RVers about, they, you know, see different kinds of rigs and different setups and, you know, get to ask questions of people who are doing exactly what they're hoping to do someday.
Yeah.
And then we also have some small businesses. There's, you know, a couple of restaurants that have parking lots. We have a few hobby farms. There's like an alpaca farm. There's a Christmas tree farm. Places that have the property and want to share it.
You know, it's funny because I'm reminded sometimes of like ham radio operators, right? You know, it's a real community and it's something that, that people aspire to do. And they you listen to people on a ham radio and they talk and they connect and they're with all people all over the place. And in, mm-hmm. in a way, the RV community is very similar. It's a real brotherhood, a real sisterhood. People just love to kind of connect with other RVers and share their experiences. And I just think it's amazing, and I'm real fascinated by the whole lifestyle. Do you have to be a host to be a guest?
No, you do not. Our hosts get perks. They can become guests for a reduced rate. They get 50% off guest privileges. But we know that not all RVers are able to reciprocate. Some might live in communities where they can't even park their own RV, let alone have guests stay, or some of our members are full-timers. They don't even have a property to offer up. So guests can join without being a host. And most of our hosts know that, you know, for many of them, that's something that they dream about, is being able to live full-time in an RV. So most of them don't, you know, begrudge anyone for not being able to reciprocate.
Tell folks where they need to go to kind of learn more about this. And also, how much does it cost?
Right. So you can learn everything about that I've just said and more at our website, which is www.boondockerswelcome.com. And the cost is right now it is $30 a year for a guest subscription. And you get a 50% discount if you list a host location. I also mentioned that hosts, in addition to getting a discount on a guest subscription, for every guest that they host, they also get subscription credits that they can then apply. You get essentially 3 months of free guest privileges membership for every guest that you have stay with you as a host. So it's currently $30 a year, but you guys will be one of the first people to know that we are actually planning a price increase on November 15th. The price will be going up to $50 a year. But for the next month, anybody who subscribes at our current $30 a year rate will get locked in at that rate. So as long as their subscription is active, then they will be locked in at that rate forever.
That's terrific. Anyone that wants to learn more about this wonderful service and opportunity and a community, just go to www.boondockerswelcome.com, right?
That's right.
And Anna, we really do appreciate your time. It was great to connect with you all the way up there in Ontario. It's up there for us. For some people, it's down there. Who knows? Or over there.
Not many people.
Not too many people north of you, right? But we do appreciate your time, and it was a lot of fun to talk to you.
Thanks very much, Tom. It was great to talk to you, too.
Anna Mast is the co-founder and CTO of Boondockers Welcome. That's boondockerswelcome.com. This is the RV Advisor Podcast. I'm Tom Alexander. Thanks so much for listening, and we'll see you next time.
You've been listening to the RV Advisor Podcast with Tom Alexander. This podcast is produced in association with Studio Alpha and Alexander Productions in Miami. Visit thervadvisor.com for more.